Joining us for more on this is the owner of Null Space Robotics Philippines, Benny Co. Hi, Benny. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking our call.
Hi. Good morning, Miss Mimi.
All right. Benny, so how big is the investment that you're making here in the Philippines? Could you give us a sense of the breadth and the scope? How big is the school? How many students are you hoping to recruit? How many teachers?
Okay. Well, we're starting small, you know. I think I mentioned in the video, so we're partnering with the ICT just to make sure that we focus first on the local government. You know, I think the mission here is to make sure that we reach the right people, you know, for this kind of education.
All right.
So we're going both, you know, the public schools and the private schools as well. So that's what we're trying to build. And we're focusing first in the Metro Manila. And as we scale, we hope to go national.
All right. So right now you have one school.
Correct. In Uptown Mall.
All right. Mm-hmm. All right. And how many students, how many teachers do you have there?
We're just about to start. So we currently have 4 instructors ready to teach 6 times a week. Mm-hmm. So we will have classes from 1 p.m. until 6 p.m. basically.
Mm-hmm. And if I'm the parent, what's the curriculum like? I mean, how long are the semesters? Do you have semesters as well, or cycles? And what time to what time, and at what price point? I guess that's one of the more important questions.
Okay. So we have different levels. So this is basically beginner friendly. Okay. So any kid, as long as there's the interest and passion to learn, then we can accommodate. So there's the beginner level, the intermediate, then the advanced level. So this could reach like up to 32 to 40 weeks, basically. So it depends on the frequency on the classes that the kid will attend as well. So the end goal is for robotics, we will want to train the kids to be to compete, you know, and that's one of the things that we're excited about, you know. So we will hold, like, in partnership with DICT to hold competitions on the national level and at the same time internationally, you know, with Null Space Singapore as well, something like that.
And the price point? Could you give our viewers an idea?
Sure. So the current price for, let's say, the Minecraft education, which for 5 sessions, which is good for 10 hours, that is 6,000 pesos. Then for the robotics, which same 5 sessions for 10 hours is 7,500.
All right. All right. And I know that you're targeting kids aged 9 to 14. Any particular reason why you selected that age group? Because I know so many schools already offering coding classes for kids as young as 5, 4,
correct,
5, 6.
Yes. So for this one, we position ourselves as the enrichment center. So the age preference is recommended by Singapore based on their years of, you know, observation and study. So the age 9 to 14, they observe that these are the stage where they're more ready, you know, to take in more complicated stuff in terms of coding and robotics. So, but again, if we have kids that's very passionate and has background like 8 years old, 7, we can still accommodate. We just have to talk to them and the parents.
And you did mention that the cycle, the whole cycle, can last 32 to 40 weeks. I'm very curious, when they complete this 40 weeks, what does a kid, what should this graduate of Null Space Robotics be able to do at the end of it?
I think they can build something from scratch and build something great, you know, so like a robot doing real things, you know. So yeah, I think like here I mentioned in my background, so we really promote a lot of innovation. We give the kids a lot of space to showcase their talent, you know. They're not following like strict from the book, you know, guidelines, but they can really innovate and do things, you know, on their own once they learn.
But the impact here, you know, would be scaling. And you mentioned this, to partner with LGUs. How do you plan to do this? And do you think our teachers are ready for this? Because you talk to teachers and many of us are still in the more traditional side of education. I mean,
correct,
STEM is not even the hottest, you know, course in town.
Correct. Well, initially, I think we're getting a lot of interest, you know, mm-hmm. especially for some teachers. I think as simple as like math, science teachers, they can easily be trained, you know, to teach this kind of programs. So I think I don't think there will be an issue with in terms of lacking, you know, of teachers that can be, you know, untrained to do this. And in terms of partnering with LGUs, as mentioned, you know, we want to make sure that not only the private schools will enjoy this kind of programs, but also the public schools. So that's why, I mean, in terms of the advocacy we're trying to create here, it should be equal opportunity for all the kids.
Mm-hmm. So what's the first target for public schools and LGU partnerships? Are you already in talks with specific LGUs? What are the goalposts?
Yeah, actually, we're DICT is really the one in charge. Mm-hmm. So we're partnered with DICT. So DICT is the one who's going through the LGUs. So I think the first one is Valenzuela City. Mm-hmm. So we already had discussions and they're going to launch, I think, sometime in July for their summer boot camp. So they already trained some of their teachers as well, you know, on this program.
Mm-hmm. I was looking at the video that we're flashing from your launch, and these are kids mm-hmm. with machines, with robots moving. Is this,
yes.
Do you teach them, is this coding like zeros and ones using a computer or more mechanical?
I think nowadays it's the Lego company, you know, or some uh-huh. of the companies doing the robots. They made it a little bit easier for the kids or the users. So uh-huh. they have code blocks. You can just drag and drop. But still, uh-huh. it requires a lot of logical thinking, you know, on how you want the robot to perform a certain task, mm-hmm. you know. So yes, this is a set, and they built that from scratch. It's not; it didn't come in like that, you know. So there's a bits of pieces like you're forming a Lego. The difference is they have motors, sensors that you have to build, and where do you put it? You know, that's the difference from the typical Lego, you know, set.
Yeah, we know, Benny, that technology evolves at breakneck speed. So what's mm-hmm. next after this? What's the next course for kids, you think, after building robots?
I think because the coding is the foundation of everything. Mm-hmm. So so once they know the coding, it can be applied in different forms. You know, so there are also other programs from Now Space Singapore that I can bring in. So they have this like STEM explorer for younger kids. You know, so and they also have like a lot of certifications for teens. You know, once they accomplish in this, you know, robotics level. So again, the bottom line, we're trying to like help nurture a lot of talents, you know, and they can excel in different forms.
Yeah. All right. Making math mm-hmm. and science very sexy there. Thank you so much, Benny, for all joining right. us, and congratulations on the launch. We look forward to meeting some of the kids soon, hopefully.
Yeah, for sure. Please, we're just in Uptown Mall, third floor, so right. come check us out. Yeah.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you,
Benny.
Me.
All right. Mm-hmm.